are starving. You look at the corruption of the earth and how it has been corrupted by companies who have taken the seeds of the earth and corrupted them. You look at the genocide that is plaguing Africa. You look at the religious, abominable teachings from the Roman Catholic Church that have indoctrinated and have drunken the nations. You look at how there is no love in the earth for one another. Satan is on this earth. Satan's not in the lake of fire now. He is not in some other realm. He's right here on the earth, under the chains of darkness. That's why you can't see him, but he is operating. He is operating, and you can see it every day if you just open your eyes. So it says, and the Lord said unto Satan, whence comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it. This is where it was. Let's read it again. In chapter 2, to make no mistake about it. Again, there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord. And Satan came also among them to present himself before the Lord. And the Lord said unto Satan, from whence comest thou? Again, Satan, from whence comest thou? Where are you coming from? And Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro on the earth, and from walking up and down in it. We read John the Revelator, Satan was cast down to the earth. See, brothers and sisters, there is a physical realm here on earth, and there is a spiritual realm. Okay? Make no mistake about it. Things happen on the physical realm that you can see, but there's a spiritual realm that things are going on that you have no conscious of. You can see that through the scriptures. You can see if you read about Micaiah and how he prophesied to Ahab and all his false prophets about how he saw Israel as sheep with no shepherd. About he prophesied about how the angels in heaven had a discussion about Ahab's death. Here, the angels and the Lord and Satan, they present themselves before the Lord. And they are discussing a man. Again, things happen on the physical realm and the spiritual realm. But let's go to Matthew 25. Let's go to Matthew, the 25th chapter. Because it's important to know, brothers and sisters, that God is to be feared. Okay, so now we get an understanding, more of an understanding of hell. Because this eternal damnation is hell fire, the lake of fire, which has not been established yet. Let's find out when this judgment is going to come upon man. Matthew 25 and verse 31 reads, when the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. So the Lord is going to make a separation when he comes in his glory. He's going to sit upon his throne, headquartered in Jerusalem, and reign as king of the earth. So he is going to divide the righteous from the unrighteous, the holy from the unholy, the sheep from the goats. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, come ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. So those that are blessed, those that are righteous, those that keep the law, statutes, and commandments of God and have faith in Jesus Christ will inherit the kingdom prepared for them from the foundation of the world. That same kingdom that he told you to pray when he told the disciples, pray thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. He says, for I was in a hunger and ye gave me meat. I was thirsty and ye gave me drink. I was a stranger and ye took me in. Naked and ye clothed me. I was sick and ye visited me. I was in prison and ye came unto me. Then shall the righteous answer as him saying, Lord, when saw we thee in a hunger and fed thee, or thirsty and gave thee drink? When saw we thee a stranger and took thee in, or naked and clothed thee? Or when saw we thee sick, or in prison, and came unto thee? And the king shall answer and say unto him, verily I say unto you, insomuch as ye have done it unto one of these, the least of these my brethren, ye have done it unto me. See, brothers and sisters, it is hypocrisy to say that you love God, whom you have not seen, but you hate your brother who you see every day. And he is made in the image, likeness of God. See, we were actually created to become God. See, we don't look like angels, we look like God. And one day, we will, if we are seen fit, those who are seen fit will meet that full potential. And it will come to pass, as he says in the Psalms, ye are gods. He said that ye shall die like men. And the death is that second death, that lake of fire. See, we all, if we don't make it to the second coming of Jesus and be resurrected in that first resurrection, are going to meet death. We're going to meet death for sin. Because death was a consequence of sin, that first death. But he has the power, Jesus has the power to raise us up from that dead and give us a celestial body. That's the reward we want. We don't want this reward. Then, in verse 41, then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. See this fire, this lake of fire, and we're talking about when the Son of Man comes in his glory. This is when it's going to be established on the earth. And brothers and sisters, it has not happened yet. And those goats on the left hand are going to go into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. He says, for I was in hunger and you gave me no meat. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger and you took me not in. Naked and you clothed me not. Sick and in prison and you visited me not. In other words, you didn't treat your brother how you would want to be treated. You didn't love your brother as you love yourself. And he said, that's grounds for putting you in a lake of fire. It's time to get our act together, brothers and sisters. It's time to be concerned about the problems and issues of our fellow man. It's time to be peaceful creatures because time is running out. Verse 45. Then shall he answer them, saying, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye did it not to one of the least of these, ye did it not to me. So because you didn't love your brother, you didn't love me. Again, it's hypocrisy to say you love God whom you have not seen, but you hate your brother whom ye see every day. 46, and these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal. Let's go to Mark, the 9th chapter. At all costs, you need to avoid the lake of fire. You need to avoid this unrighteous reward. Mark, the 9th chapter, and verse 42. This is Jesus' warning about hell, the lake of fire. This everlasting fire that you want to avoid at all costs. Mark 9 and 42 reads, and whosoever shall offend one of these least little ones that believe in me, it is better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck and he were cast into the sea. See, and if thy hand offend thee, cut it off. It is better for thee to enter into life maimed than having two hands to go into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched. Again, we read that this fire will last forever. It's eternal. It will not end. What the Lord is going to do is going to resurrect the unrighteous and the righteous, but he's going to resurrect the unrighteous to eternal damnation. Give them a body that will not die and then torment them forever. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be a part of that. It's time to get our house in order, brothers and sisters. So it says, and if thy hand offend thee, cut it off. It is better for thee to enter into life maimed than having two hands to go into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched. See, this is what will keep you in line. Fear of going to hell. Being fearful of experiencing eternal damnation. That will keep you in line. It says, well, the worm dies not and the fire is not quenched. So it's this eternal death. Just like when a man or woman dies and they are put into the ground, worms eat the flesh. They devour that carcass. Well, you're going to have a carcass that will not die. And it's going to burn forever. And worms are going to eat at it. And he says, if thy hand offend thee, cut it off. It is better for thee to enter into life maimed than having two hands to go into hell. You won't go into eternal life or get a celestial body that is main, brothers and sisters. What he's telling you is the importance of getting your act together. He's telling you that whatever you have to do, you need to do it. So if you got a problem with stealing,